bringing STEM to young women and more women to STEM. I'm Tonya Hall for ZDNet and Tech Republic, and joining me is Mercedes Soria. She is the Executive Vice President and Chief Intelligence Officer at Knightscope. Welcome, Mercedes.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So Knightscope makes some pretty awesome security robots. Tell us about your role at the company.
So I was employee number three. I barely missed the founder title. So the two founders got together and decided to do security. They've been in security for a long time. And then when the need arose for a software person, that's when then I got involved and I started leading all of the software engineering efforts. Because some of the things that people don't know is Knightscope has robots out there, but there is software that actually massages all the data that comes out of these robots. So that is what I do at Knightscope.
You won the 2017 ABIE Award for Leadership. Tell us about antbie.org and the significance of the award.
So antbie.org is a community of female technologists from around the world. There's over 100 countries that are involved with that organization. And what it does is it helps women getting more integrated in STEM careers, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. So there's a ABIE conference every year where there's 18,000 to, I think, 20,000 one time, women technologists from around the world that meet, get together, and enjoy about a week of events and mingling with each other and knowing about programs that are specifically for women is a way to encourage us all to, hey, there's more women like you in technology, go meet them, go talk to them, go mentor them if you're in that situation. So I won the leadership award, and that was mainly focused on the work that I did while I was at Deloitte & Touche and the current work that I did today. So I spent about a little bit over 10 years at Deloitte & Touche as the only female technologist in a group of 40 people, and I was the manager and everybody else was doing the work. So that's when I started to see there's just not enough women in this engineering career, and computer science is just so very few. So I made it my job to mentor women at Deloitte who were just starting their career. I went to the level of mentoring some that we just went to recruiting trips. So I would meet girls that are even from high school, not even in college yet, who were interested in maybe doing internships at Deloitte at some point in their careers. So my job was to go to those conferences, talk to them, interview them, and then figure out who could be a potential good intern or a potential good full-time employee at Deloitte. And when they joined, I made it my mission to ensure that they had everything that they needed to be able to do a really good job when they're there. So I by the time I counted, I think I mentored between 40 and 50 women while I was there. And then now I am part of a Department of State program called Tech Women, which takes my mentoring skills to a whole new level because I am mentoring women entrepreneurs and science and technology who come from around the world to the United States for 5 weeks of mentorship with other women entrepreneurs here in the country.
How do we increase women's representation and success in STEM?
So one of the things that people always bring up the number that, oh, there's more women now graduating than men. That is true. Yes, that exists. But there's still not enough women graduated from technology degrees. And what I think, what I've tried to do is you have to get to women when they're still young. Because by the time they finish high school or by the time they're half in college, they're not as much interested in technology because it's not as cool, right? It's always not something that comes to the top of their minds. So I think we need to get to women early. Education is a big, big, big point because there's a lot of organizations out there that are focused on helping women in technology. There's Girls Who Code, there's Women in Tech, there's Women in Technology International. There's so many of them, but a lot of the women in the field just don't know about them. So there's a lot of education that needs to take place. And some of those organizations are doing some of that, but there's still more effort that needs to be put in place, I think.
What needs to change with the education system? What classes should we emphasize and how do we make it compelling?
So one of the things that we see, and I've read some of these as well, is by the year 2030 or by the year 2040, computer programming is no longer going to be a career that you pick when you're in school. It's going to be something that you learn as your math basic studies, your biology basic studies. Anybody who goes to college will have to know how to program. I think when we get there, now we're starting from the beginning, right? From zero, from men and women, and they will be equal. And at that point, it will be so much less of the stigma that is associated with the programmer type of person, right? Somebody who doesn't talk to anyone, somebody who's not social, all they care about is their computer. That is the stigma that we have to change.
Talk about your mentorship and mentoring in Africa and Asia.
So what they do is we pick women. The State Department of the U.S. works with the State Department in different countries. This is from Africa, Southeast Asia, and people at places like Lebanon and places like that in the Middle East. So what we do is we get it is a whole year commitment. It starts around February or March when those embassies apply us. Talk about the program to women in other countries. So there's a lot of women that apply to come to the program. There's like 4,000 or 5,000 that apply, but there are only about 100, 120 that get to come to the US. So we do, I am involved in everything from the evaluation of their first admission, when they talk about the project they're gonna work, they want to work on, how technology has been a central part of their lives, and what accomplishes the what they have accomplished in the past with their in their countries. So based on those merits and based on the type of mentors that we have here in the U.S., we match the group together, and that's how we decide. Okay, this person can come and this person can't, because if somebody in Africa is interested in biochemistry, but we don't have that year of biochemistry person, then we can't match them, right? So we work on it all year long to find more mentors, to grade these applications. When they come here, we receive them, we mentor them for 5 weeks, we do a pitch event, and they even can win some grants from the United States Department of, the Department of State, to get their companies started. So we even, and for me, at least in my case, I'm not sure if this happens with everyone, but in my case, I mentor them even after they're gone. So I've had two groups that I've mentored 2 years after they left. One of them has a startup that is healthy and growing in Tunis, and the other one has a small business that they started as a mentorship program out there in Lebanon.
Are women mentoring other women enough?
I think we're getting better. There's more programs. Like I said, there's more programs, but we can always do better, right? It's obviously, if you see that out there, there's not enough women in technology, and we even see a gap in terms of how much more money women make compared to how much a man with that same job would make. We still have a lot of progress to make, and especially here in the Valley, companies like your Facebooks, your Googles, big companies show their diversity numbers, and the improvement is a mere 1 or 2% per year. So one of the small things that I can do that I'm trying to do at Knightscope is to get a ratio of 50-50 of women to men. And that's very hard because this is a technology company, so we're looking for women who specifically don't go into the careers that we're looking for. But we're at about 28%, so pretty happy. We keep going up every year, so we work on it.
Can men be effective mentors for women?
Absolutely. I particularly had a bad experience with a mentor. This was when I was working at Deloitte. I always wanted to have someone who will kind of show me the ropes and tell me how to get to the places that I wanted to get. And I was very involved in things like the Hispanic community, the Diversity and Inclusion Board, all of those organizations when I was at Deloitte. And then I decided to find a mentor. There was a mentor matching program. And when I met with a mentor that was assigned to me, I did not pick if it was men or women. I didn't care. So I chose a man. And when I had my first meeting with him, he told me, tell me what you do with your career. So I told him, I'm a member of this group. I go to these meetings. I do these projects. I told him everything that I did. And he basically looked at me and he said, I'm sorry, you're doing everything you're supposed to do. There's nothing I can contribute. There's nothing I can do to help you. And I was like, what? So that was the main reason that really forced me and inspired me to help other women, because I don't want other women to have the same experience, right? Whether it comes for a man or for a woman, that's just not something good to go through when you're trying to improve yourself. So after that, I've had mentors who are a lot better, who help me. I mean, they've helped me with a lot of things, from how to write a summary of a resume, how I have a meeting, I have an interview, things like that that are kind of sort of new to me a little bit. So I think men and women can be just as equal, if not better, mentor for other women. It's just a matter of us finding where they are.
So finally, what advice do you have for young women who are considering a career in STEM?
Technology is cool. Technology is absolutely cool. If you want to be involved in the world of tomorrow, if you want your dreams to be true, you need to start in technology. Technology is very cool.
Mercedes Soria, Executive Vice President and Chief Intelligence Officer at Knightscope. Thank you so much for joining me and giving us some advice on how to encourage more young women to pursue a career in STEM. If somebody wants to connect with you, maybe they want to find out more about your work or get some advice, how can they do that?
Thank you so much to you for having me. If somebody wants to get in touch with me, it's pretty easy. It's my name, Mercedes Soria, no spaces, and Twitter. So that's the best way to reach out to me, just Mercedes Soria and Twitter, and I will respond to your message.
Sounds good. And if you want to find more of my interviews, you can do that right here on ZDNet or Tech Republic, or maybe go to my website, tonyahall.net. I've got links to all my social sites. Thanks for watching.